Well, the pharmaceutical companies have big dollars. They can come in phase three. One phase three trial in Alzheimer's costs $300 to $400 million, and you need two or three of them to get, maybe four to get an FDA approval, right? So Biogen's risking up to $3 billion on their aducanumab at this point. Okay, that's a big risk. So you can't take many of those bets, right, without going out of business. And a lot of big pharma companies have left not just Alzheimer's, but the whole CNS space because it's so risky. Okay, and you can't run a company, with such large risks, as financial and scientific risk. Same thing with venture capital. Okay, they have 10-year funds. Well, it takes 12 to 15 years to develop a drug, right? So they're tending to step in late. They want to see, generally speaking, phase two data. I mean, there are some VC funds that'll step in earlier into the preclinical space, but most of them won't. And they, because again, for the same reason, they have obligations to their investors to make money. And that's a good thing because if a drug is brought to market, everybody wins. But where they can put their money is in a different place in the pipeline. A venture philanthropy, the role of philanthropy in our society is to take risk, and that's what we do. So we're in this space of drug discovery and development, but we're the ones who can take risk, okay? So if somebody comes to me, like Hank Kung, who came to me to get this amyloid scan going back in 2000, no one would give him any money. And I funded that thing for 4 years at the University of Pennsylvania. Now it's a revolutionary technology. Back then, he couldn't get any money. So we're doing this all the time. I've funded over 95 biotechnology company programs in the last 18 years. A lot of companies out there now that have really interesting drugs that are in development, and they're having trouble getting investors. So we fund them. NIH provides some funding to them. It's not a great way to run a company to do it on grants, but the role of the foundation, we have a really good due diligence. We're known for that. We're nonprofits, so we don't really have any bias, we hope. We know the investor community, and we can fund these things. We make investments. These are investments that the foundation is making. And we can move programs forward into the clinic, and hopefully with our money through the valley of death, companies can survive to a point where they can pivot and get pharmaceutical deals or venture capital investment and pull it all the way through to phase three.